So in my previous classes, I have explained you various instructions. One set of instructions are left in this module 2. So those are load and store instructions. Okay. As I said, ARM is a load store architecture. That means ARM can communicate with the memory. That means ARM can either store a data in the memory or load data from the memory. It can only do these two things using two instructions, load and store. No other instructions which you have studied in this module can directly operate on data present in memory. Okay, so whatever the data is there in the memory, either you want to store it or the data, either you want to apply any instruction on the data stored in the memory, you have to first load that data into a register, apply in any operations you want to apply on that register, and then store it back to the memory. So you cannot apply any type of instructions or operations on memory directly. So here today, in today's class, I will there are three parts in load store instruction as per the syllabus. So in today's class, I will only explain first part, and in tomorrow's class, I will explain the remaining two parts. Okay. So these are the three categories, okay, that we have to discuss today and tomorrow. So single register transfer load store instruction, multiple register transfer load store instruction, and swap. Okay. Swap, I think you know, okay, that is a data exchange, right, between memory and registers. Now initially, before going to single register transfer, let us see what is load store, what are load store instructions. So you know load store instruction is used to transfer data between memory and processor registers. So there are 16 registers R0 to R15 available in the ARM, and memory. Memory means it is a primary memory or RAM. Okay. So what happens is when data is there in the memory and you want to apply a particular operation or instruction on that data, ARM processor do not allow to apply any operation directly on the data present in the memory. Any operation you want to apply on the data present in the memory, the memory data must be loaded into a register and then operation has to be applied. That means, very in simple words, I will tell ARM do not allow any operations, right, on data directly present in the memory. Okay, ARM allows operation on registers only. So memory purpose is just to store. Okay, so you can only load memory data into a register, or from a register you can store it into the memory. All other operations has to be done on the registers itself. So load store instruction. ARM is also called load store architecture. Okay, which allows programmer only to load and store memory data and do not allow any other operations on memory data. Three types of load store instruction. Okay, single register, multiple register, and swap. So in today's class, I will explain what is single register transfer. I'll tell you before starting this one, as we have done almost I think 6 lab programs, we are almost most of the time we have used load store instruction. Okay, especially array operations and all those things. Related to array, we have to access array every element one by one. That time we have used load instruction, right, many times. So here I will clearly explain what exactly load and store instructions. Now we will talk about only single register transfer. Now what is single register transfer load store instruction? That means either if it is a load instruction, we select maximum of 32-bit data from the memory and store it into a single register, any register, single register. Right, there are 16 registers R0 to R15 in the ARM. We can use any register, but only one register is involved in the load or store. That means if it is a load instruction, you can fetch data from the memory and store it in a single register. Or if it is a store operation, then store instruction, then you can store a data from a single register into a memory. Now your maximum size of data that can be transferred is 32-bit. Why? That is because the size, maximum size of the register available, right, in the, I mean all the registers in the ARM are 32-bit in size. So if you fetch 64-bit data from the memory, you cannot store it in a single register. So that's why here data type supported are signed or unsigned values. Okay, You can load sign or unsigned number, that is plus or minus numbers, but it should be either 32 bit or 16 bit or a byte. Okay, 32 bit is called word. The 32 bit size data is called word. 16 bit data is called half word, and byte, that is 8 bit data. Okay, so these are the syntaxes here we have given here, load and store instruction syntax. Okay, we can understand it very better when we start giving examples. Okay, always remember, whether it is load or store, okay, the first operand is register. Okay, and second operand is always address. Address of the memory you are referring. Whether it is load, okay, or store, always remember the direction of data transfer here. The way we represent operand, source and destination will never change. Unlike any other instructions, right? We have studied lot of instructions where first operand is always destination. Now in store instruction, we are transferring data from register to address, right? At location which is mentioned here in the destination operand. But we do not change the position of register and address. Here always first operand is register, second operand is always address, whether it is load instruction or store instruction. So what is LDR and STR? LD means load, R means register. Load register, store register. Okay, LDR or SDR. So that is how we mention here. So now there are two different syntaxes for both. So common syntax is this one, LDR and STR. I will mark this here. So this is the common syntax, first one, okay, where either you can use LDR or STR. Where first register is always, first operand is always register, second operand is always address. If it is a load instruction, from this address in the memory, data will be loaded to register, given register. Okay? Or if it is a store instruction, then data from the register will be copied to the memory location mentioned in the second operand as the address. So that's all. Okay? So now here, so load and store instruction comes with condition, a conditional execution. You know this conditional execution. So load and store instruction, you can execute based on a condition. Okay, the truthness of condition, whether it's true or false. And you can also have a B. Okay, that is for branching. Okay, that is for a branching. We don't discuss it in this syllabus. Okay. Then I told you can load or store 32 bit data or 16 bit data or 1 byte 8 bit data, right? How to mention whether what amount of data we have to load or store? So that is here, right? See, the load operation is here. Okay, you can see load instruction. Okay, when you simply write LDR and STR and you write one register and one address, it is always 32 bit data get transferred. Okay, load and store by default transfer 32 bit data. Otherwise you have to mention like this here. In my second syntax, we'll go for load. In the load instruction, okay, you have to mention whether you are transferring half word, okay, or byte, okay, signed byte, okay, signed half word. So whether by using those suffix with the instruction, you can mention a byte or 16 bit or 32 bit. We'll give example. Your store also, just like that, you can store H. Okay, that is half word. Okay, so do you remember this syntax? Okay, and meaning of the syntax we are explaining with the example. So here is the example, this table. If you remember this table, that's enough for examination purpose, where you can rewrite this theory, entire theory. Okay, so okay. So let us see LDR instruction. See LDR instruction. When you simply use LDR instruction, okay, so LDR syntax I told you, LDR, then RD, okay, one register and one address, right? So now what happens when you simply LDR, whatever the address you have mentioned, from that address, 32 bit of memory data will be transferred to the, what is that, operand register, register operand, right? So this is how it works, right? So always remember, LDR instruction or store instruction always comes with first operand as register, second operand as address. So whatever the address you have mentioned in second operand, from that address 32 bit data will be copied to a given register. Store is also same case. From the register, we know that all registers are 32-bit in by default. So 32-bit register, from 32-bit register, if it is a store instruction, the 32-bit data will be copied to the right memory whose address is mentioned in the second operand of the STR. Right? So this operand I am talking about here, address. Right? In all, I told you, in all load and store instructions, second operand is address, first operand is register. So now, so that is 32-bit data transfer, LDR and STR, load and store, 32-bit data transfer. Then we have B, see LDRB, STRB. So it is very simple, it is 8-bit. Right? If it is a load instruction, whatever the address you have mentioned in second operand, from that address, 8-bit data or 1 byte of data will be copied to RD register. Now you might ask me one doubt, that RD is 32-bit register. When you copy 8-bit data into RD, what happens to remaining 24-bit of data? It will be sign extended, or I can say basically it is 0. Okay, remaining data will be set 0. Okay, that I will tell, because when I mention LDR STR or LDRB STRB, I have not mentioned here letter S. S means signed. Okay, S means signed. So here these all four register, four data transfer are unsigned. Okay, unsigned means processor thinks there is no sign for data getting transferred, no positive or no negative. So what happens is, when 8 byte data is copied to a 32 bit data register, remaining 24 bit on left hand side or remaining 24 bit of MSB values, MSB 24 bits will be copied as 0. Right, will be copied as 0, always remember this. Okay, and store RB is the same thing. See, RD is 32 bit, register is 32 bit. Out of those 32 bit, which 8 bit we copy to given address in memory? Here storing, no, storing byte. 32 bit means 4 byte. Right? 32 bit alli, yava 8 bits we copy into the memory from the register? Of course, right? LSB 8 bits. Always it is LSB 8 bits. We know binary starts from LSB to move towards MSB. So LSB 8 bits of the register will be copied to this memory. When 8-bit data is transferred from memory to register, it will be get transferred to the LSB 8 bits. Remaining 24 MSB bits will be 0, because these are unsigned. Four above four instructions are unsigned instructions, because there is no S mentioned. Right? Now let us say signed operations here. Four operations. Load RH. Okay? Load H means half word. So here 32-bit data transfer we studied, 8-bit data transfer we studied. Now remaining is 16-bit data transfer. So here also it is unsigned, okay? These two also unsigned, because there is no S, capital letter S, okay? 16-bit data, right? 8-bit as 16-bit data, right? Load RH means load register half word, means 16-bit data or 2-byte data from the address mentioned in the LDRH instruction will be copied to the register, okay, mentioned in the LDRH instruction. 16-bit remaining, because the register is 32-bit, remaining 16-bit which are MSB bits are 0. Always remember, store RH is also same case. It stores RH half word, 16-bit. LSB 16-bit of RD register will be copied to given address in the memory. Okay, LSB 16-bits. Okay, this is how it works. 16-bit, 32-bit, the order of this table is not proper. It's okay, no problem. Okay, so 32-bit here, how to copy 32-bit data from memory to register and register to memory. Here how to copy 16-bit data from register to memory, memory to register. And how to copy 8-bit data from memory to register and register to memory. Okay, only thing always remember, these registers are always 32-bit. When you copy any data less than 32-bit, which part of the register will get replaced? That's very important, only LSB side. MSB side will be 0. Why? All these, right, 6 instructions you can see here are unsigned. How can I say? There is no letter S mentioned. There is no letter S mentioned. So let's see remaining signed operation here. See, there are 2 instructions mentioned here where there is a letter S. Means these are signed. These are signed in this sign, and these are byte and word. Okay, half word. Okay, when you register is 32 bits and you are loading a 32-bit data, so the 32-bit will get filled. All 32 bits of register will be get filled. So there is no way to think whether it is positive number or negative number. Why? Because in binary, positive or negative number are represented by MSB bit. This is you should know, okay, from computer organization course, how negative numbers are represented. Okay, signed number, sorry, how signed numbers are represented. Where we mention sign? Is it possible in binary to mention plus or minus? No, binary stores only 1 or 0. So that's why the MSB bit, okay, last bit of the data, MSB bit, means if the 32-bit data, right, the last bit will be used to mention whether number is negative or positive. Okay, if last bit, MSB bit is 1, number is negative. If MSB bit is 0, number is positive. Now when you load 32-bit data, okay, when you load 32-bit data, register is also 32-bit, entire 32-bit get occupied. So we nothing to worry about whether there is a positive or negative. But what happens is, when the data you are loading here is either 16-bit or 8-bit and register is 32-bit, you have to fill remaining bits. Okay, unlike unsigned instruction where we filled all zero remaining MS bits as zero, here we don't fill zeros because these are signed numbers. We extend the sign. What is sign extension? Okay, this is also you must know what is sign extension. I'll tell you once again. If you don't know, okay, you should know this sign extension, very important. Load RB, loading byte and as a sign number, loading 1 byte sign number into a register, 32-bit register. So what happens is 8-bit data, that is 1 byte will copy LSB 8 bits of registers. 32-bit register, LSB 8 bit will be copied by the data you have loaded. Okay, what happens remaining 24 bit, it is sign extended. That means whatever the 8-bit data you transfer, the last 8th bit, MSB bit, will be copied to all other 24 bit. Okay, all other 24. For example, if I want to give an example, I'll show here. The data I'm loading is 8-bit data I'm loading is 10101111. So this is the 8-bit data I want to load. It will be copied to a register which is 32-bit, right? So what happens, these 8 bit will sit here in LSB 8 bits from right side, right? 8 bit are occupied. So remaining 24 bit, what happens? The last bit of the 8 bit data, what is the last bit here, 8 bit? 1. So all 24 bits will be 1. Suppose if last bit was 0, all 24 bits will be 0. Because we consider whatever the data we fetch, last bit as sign bit. Okay, last bit of the data we fetch is signed bit. So remaining bits in the register will be copied with that bit. Okay, whether it is 8-bit data or 16-bit data. Okay, register is 32-bit. When you load 16-bit data, MSB 16-bit will be remain vacant. Okay, so that time also we made sign extension. Last bit of the loaded data will be copied to remaining bits of the register. Okay, this is only issue appears when we are loading byte or half word. That is 8-bit or 16-bit. 32-bit when you load, all 32-bit will get vacant. There is no vacant, all 32-bit of register will get occupied. So there will be no way to think whether which sign has to be extended, because there is no way to extend. All 32 bits are occupied. Okay. So this is how this load and store instruction works here. Okay. So always remember the meaning of this instruction and syntax. Okay. So they can ask any specific instruction in exam. Simply they can mention explain LDRB or explain LDRSH. Okay, then you have to mention the statement, this syntax also, the previous slide again, syntax alidadu, and also example. Okay, so here. Now, so in this example we have, so this is about your load and store. Now the question is here, how to mention, okay, here register. See, I told you first operand in load store instruction is always register. Oh, we'll mention any register. Okay. Second operand is always address. Now question is how to mention this address. What is the addressing mode? Okay. What is the addressing mode? Can I directly mention address as a number? Right? Hash zero. Like I want to fetch, for example, I come here. Can I write like this, load R, okay, into R0. A 32-bit value. I want to copy 32-bit value into R0 from the memory address hash 123. I mean 1234. Okay, this is my address 1234. If I write like this, okay, it is wrong. if I give within square bracket and treat it as address, this is the right way. Okay, when you write a number within a square bracket, it will be treated as an address. Okay, this is the right way. But ARM do not support this. What ARM wants is, ARM wants address to be mentioned in register only. ARM wants address to be mentioned in register only. But ARM supports various addressing modes. Means, I'll tell you, this is we have used in our previous section, previous class, I explained how to access every element of an array. Right? Okay. So how to use this? So you store 1, 2, 3, 4 in any register, like R1. Okay? I'm storing 1, 2, 3, 4 value into R1 and using R1 within square bracket. So this is how we mention. Okay, I'll tell you clearly one thing here. I am loading R0 32-bit value, 32-bit data I'm loading into R0 register from a memory address whose address is in R1. That's why R1 is written within square bracket. Right? Your syntax is perfect now. Here is the register, here is the address. Right? First instruction, first operand is register, second operand is address. So that's the concept. I got it right? Yeah. Here also, store also same thing. See? Store only, see here data transfer, look at the direction of data transfer. In every instruction, ARM instruction, right? Destination, first register is destination register. Data transfer is always like this. Right? Destination register is the first operand. Here now in store only, from R0, we are copying 32-bit data to a memory location whose address is mentioned in R1. Correct? This is the address, this is the register. But data transfer is from left to right. Right? That's what I am telling. We are not interchanging source and destination operands in load and store. In load and store, first operand must be the register, second operand must be the address. So data transfer takes between address into register or register to address. Okay. Now, look at the comment section here. That is really interesting. Look at the comment section here. So what is this? See, when you write like this, okay, when you write a first operand as a register and second operand is nothing but address, okay, and this addressing mode we call is a register indirect addressing mode. Why? Address is in R1 register and we are using R1 register as an address, right? We are directly not mentioning address here. Instead, indirectly storing address in R1 and using R1. Right, as an address register, so called indirect register indirect addressing mode. Okay, this is register indirect addressing mode. But how exactly processor treat that instruction that is written in this comment section? Processor always treat this instruction. Here you can see processor. I'll remove whatever written. It will get a little confusing. Okay, yeah. Processor treats this instruction this way because processor do not operate. ARM processor do not operate in register indirect addressing mode. Okay, register indirect addressing mode. You computer organization and heli there. What are the addressing modes? Register indirect address mode. What programmer writes here by indirectly storing address in a register and using that register in the address field here within square bracket. But the register indirect addressing mode, ARM do not consider. ARM will consider it as base plus offset addressing mode. ARM automatically converts it into base plus offset addressing mode. Means a base register here. Okay, that is a base register plus offset. What is plus offset? Because offset is nothing but it will be added to base register and total value calculation is done. Okay, so here I don't want to add anything to R1. I am simply writing R1. So that's a processor thing. Offset is 0. So what happens? R1 plus 0. So total address becomes whatever the content of R1 itself. Right? If content of R1 is 1, 2, 3, 4, here total address is finally, right, 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 0. So address is 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Okay? Instead of hash 0, if I write 10, 1, 2, 3, 4 will become 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 4. 10 will be added. Why? Base offset register is nothing but final address is calculated by adding base and offset value. Base and offset value. Did you get this? This is very important. How ARM treats, here also see, how ARM treats addressing modes. Now how, where exactly it helps? It helps us in the array. It helps us in the array. I will explain that also. So I hope you understand this concept. Even though I write like this, see, can I write like this? Yes, you are allowed to write like this. You are allowed, as a program, you are allowed to write like this. Even if you don't write like that, if you write these as like these two instructions, processor treat it as like this. Okay, that's how it works. So let's see next. Single load store. We are talking about single register transfer, right? Till now, okay. How to transfer from one register to memory or memory to a particular register? Here there are three different addressing modes. Actually, your ARM supports very important. Okay. When you write load or store instruction, okay, I told you if you write it as register in that addressing mode, it will be considered as base plus offset addressing. Okay, base plus offset addressing. Based on that, actually ARM supports three addressing modes: pre-index with write back, pre-index without write back, or pre-index then post-index. This is simply just like in higher level language you call it as pre-increment and post-increment. Okay, pre-increment and post-increment. Okay, so these are the index addressing modes, right? Base plus offset with index addressing mode. Okay, so this is how ARM treats file actually. Okay, so three modes ARM supports. Okay, and I will give example with everything. Okay, nothing to worry. Okay, you remember, whenever you mention load or store instruction for a single register, you are loading data from memory and storing it in a 32-bit register, or okay, copying 32-bit register data into a memory. Maybe the data size is 8 bit, 16 bit or 32 bit. I am just talking about load LDR and STR instruction. Then you can mention address in these three types. Okay, I am talking about address, how to mention address. First operand is array register. Second operand is address. How to mention that address in these three ways, that is possible ways. Okay, so let us see pre-index with write back. Okay, here the table is here. ಈ ಟೇಬಲ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ತ್ರೀ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ, ರೈಟ್? 1, 2, 3, ರೈಟ್? ದೇರ್ ಅ ಡೇಟಾ. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೇಟಾ? ವಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟಾ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಾಪಿಂಗ್? ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟಾ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಾಪಿಂಗ್? ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಎನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಜೀರೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಜೀರೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್, ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಜೀರೋ ಆರ್ ಒನ್. ಹೌ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್? Okay, processor treats it like this. R1 will be treated like this. R1 comma hash 0, right? No offset basically, but you can mention in this format only. You can mention an offset also. Okay, now this, where memory, which is the data we are fetching actually, or where exactly we are storing the data? Okay, this is load, we are fetching. If it is store instruction, we are storing, but from which address? The finally the memory location we are copy referring to store or load. The memory address we are referring is the R1 base plus 0, that is offset. That's what he is saying, base plus offset. Okay, these two works with pre-index and pre-index with write back. Post-index, what happens? Post-index is the post-increment. What happens? We will consider R1, that is base address, okay, to fetch or store the memory. Once it is done, then R1 will be incremented with the given offset. We will increment it later. One, we directly mention base. Did you understand base and offset? I will write here one example: LDR, okay, R0 and R1 comma hash, okay, 0 initially. 0 to 10, yen bodu yav value ku kodbu ni index, okay, offset. So in post index en martive andre, we will fetch data from the address mentioned in the R1 register. Once data is fetched in stored, then R1 will be incremented with the offset. So that's why here written base plus offset. R1 will be base, register will be uploaded. You must know what is base register. See, I'll go back if you have the confusion. See here in this sentence, I mentioned the register you mentioned is the base register. Then comma, whatever value you write, then offset. Somebody's mic is turned on. Please turn off your mic. Okay, base register. See, destination register bagi maatadtilla. I am talking about only addressing, right? When you mention address, the register you mention is called base register, and the value you mention extra with comma is called offset. Now here look at this. Okay, in all three index they have mentioned what is the method from where actually data gets copied. I mean, data gets copied in which memory location we are finally talking about in that instruction, where we are storing the memory data into the memory, or which from which part of the memory we are copying the data. So that is the address, final address we calculate, that is here. This is a base register. What happens after executing instruction with the base register? Right? In my example, LDR R0 comma R1 comma hash 0 in this instruction, what is the base register of this R1? What happens with the R1 content finally? In post index, I told you, we copy only base register as the address. We consider whatever the R1 value is there, that address as the address. Okay? We store the data in that address or we copy data from that address. But it is a post increment, right? Post index. What happens? But R1 will be incremented by the offset. R1 plus hash 0 and store back in the R1. Okay, what will be the base address value after? Okay, so you can ask me, sir, what happens? Does base register really change, value changes? Yes, base register value changes, only it doesn't change in this pre-index mode. See, not updated. R1 will remain R1 only. Right? Okay, so this is the syntax. Look at the syntax. We have used this syntax in my array program, in my previous lab program. Right? Do you remember this? We have written this, right? Whenever this is the array, this is the array, and R1 points to an array element, okay? So this is the statement I always written, right? This statement, do you remember? What is that? Load R0, R1 means this element I am copying to R0 using R1. But comma hash 4, what is that comma hash 4? R1 will be updated to next pointer, R1, because every array element is 4 byte. So hash 4. R1 will be automatically incremented and start pointing to the next element. That's it. So every time I fetch an element, I will always point that, make R1 to point next element. Right? Means I am fetching data from current R1 pointer. But after fetching the data, I am making R1 to point to next element. So that's what we used in my previous lab program. Okay? So this is how it works. Syntax. Three different addressing mode to mention address and their syntax is here, example syntax. Yeah. Okay. I hope this table you can understand now. I'll give example for all three. See, pre-index with write back. Pre-index with write back, where we mention whatever the base register is there and half that within a single square bracket. Within a single square bracket. Can you see? Square bracket starts here, ends here in write back. Followed by a exclamator. I hope exclamator in a end character. Okay. Exclamatory sign that shows write back means what it what does it means pre-index is the pre-increment. We don't fetch data from the address mentioned in R1. We fetch data from address R1 plus offset. Right? Whatever R1 value is plus 4. Our address is the mentioned. See, what is R1 value here? 9000. Plus 4, 9004. And 9004 memory, at 9004 memory, this is the value we are fetching. And copying it to R0. So can you see R0 value? Yes. R0 value is this. Correct? Now look at the R1. Look at the R1 value. R1 value has also changed. Base address is changed. Why? We have written a write back. So R1 plus 4, 9004, which is the address we are copying. And that 9004 is also copied to R1, write back. We have written back to the R1, the newly calculated address, base plus offset. Okay, base plus offset. So what happens if I don't mention write back, this symbol, it is not mentioned. Okay, it will become pre-index, but not with write back. That means we fetch data from this 9004 only. But value of the R1 will not change. So I'll show that example here in my next slide. See, here that write back symbol here is missing. Correct, no? Write back symbol is missing. Now what happened? R1 value is 9000, but R1, we have written base and offset, right? Base plus offset, both base and offset within single square bracket. So it is pre-index. So it is pre-index. So R1 plus 4, that is 9000 plus 4, 9004. From that address 9004, we will fetch data and copy it to R0. Right? We copy to R0. Now what about the R1 register? There is no write back. Means R1 was initially 9000. After it also it is 9000. But we fetch data from 9004. But R1 will remain. It is not written back. Newly calculated address is not written back to the R1. Now what is the post index? Post index will write back until. Post index, there is no write back. It is post increment. means we fetch data from the memory address mentioned in the R1. What is R1? 9000. So what is 9000? This data. It will be copied to, of course, R0. Right? R0 here. And look at the R1 now. Of course, R1 remains. R1 is 9000, but it is now become 9004. Why? We copy data from the register value address mentioned in the register R1. After fetching the data, we will increment R1. So that R1 points to the next element in array. Okay? So this is post index. Post index is always write back, but post index do not fetch data from the address after adding. First we fetch data mentioned in the address register, base register. Then we update base register with by 4 or whatever the offset we mentioned. Okay? So this is about single register transfer. Okay? So there are various addressing concepts here. You can go through this pre-indexing with different addressing modes. Okay, different addressing modes. Okay, this is the addressing relative really. Syntax they have mentioned. For example, if I write LDR R1, comma, the address whatever I have to mention here, only that part is discussed here. Various type of addressing you can mention. Because we not discuss here signed and unsigned. See, there is signed and unsigned also. Right? There is signed and unsigned also. Okay? These addressing modes, you try to understand, okay, these addressing modes. Whether it is written in single square bracket or whether it is written after the square bracket. So various concepts are there. Okay, you have to go through all this table. I think I have given enough introduction so that you can understand this table. Okay, that's your homework. Okay, here also same concept. Look at this. They have given some example, okay, with different addressing modes. The example, okay, not syntax, they have given example. What happens? So that you can understand LDR instruction with the pre-index and write back, pre-index and post-index mode. They have given some example, okay? And they are finding the final. See what happens finally R1. What will we get added to the R1? Okay? Right? R1 register, that's the base register. Whether we add the offset 4 or whether we add a new register value or whether we don't add anything, what we are going to add to R1? Okay, after write back here R1 plus equal and you know, here this means what R1 plus equal, R1 plus equal to R1 equal R1 plus, right? R1 equal R1 plus, isn't it? This is how you write. And yen add martava R1, yen add martava, so aage bitteva, R1 modulo value in it, aage continue martava, whether it is a write back or we simply keep continuing. Okay, that's what they have discussed. And what is the R0? That is the content. What will be copied to the R0 content? Which address is considered? Directly R1 address is considered or R1 plus 4 is considered or whatever, which some other register is considered. You can also mention register. See, offset can also be mentioned in register. Offset can also be mentioned through a barrel shifter, inline barrel shifter. Okay? Yeah, it is not as simple as you think. Also, it is not as complex as you think. You have to simply sit and think, see every register and instruction they have used. Okay, so this is how. Here again, they have mentioned addressing mode, pre-index and post-index, all those things. But with this concept, half word, signed half word, or signed byte, or double. Sign mentioned material, not in plus and minus. Okay, and half set is whether 8 bit, right, or you have mentioned a register state. Okay, so all these things you have to go through. Okay, table and explain madi upayogilla new other they work to. Okay, they don't ask these tables in exam, but you should understand this. Okay, here they have only discussed strh instruction. Only there is some little bit changes in strh. They have discussed what is store half word. Okay, store half word. What is the strh instruction? Strh. Okay, illa vandi adana example helthe strh instruction here. Okay, we'll take okay, this example, okay, no problem, STRH. We are copying 32-bit data, LSB 32-bit data, 16-bit. LSB 16-bits of R0 will be copied to some address here. And how this address can vary, that's what they have mentioned with pre-index and post-index. Anything, STRH and the variable, even some examples so that you can understand. They have given multiple tables, okay, with a different syntax here, with different example, again new syntax, again example, okay. So that's how you have to go through how to transfer a single register data from register to memory or memory to register. Okay, single register load store instruction. In next class we will study multiple register. What is multiple register load store transfer? In a single load or store instruction, you can copy multiple register values into memory, or you can copy multiple memory data into store into multiple registers. That means one thing is very clear, the data finally getting transferred is greater than 32 bit, isn't it? If data is maximum 32 bit, we can store it in a single register itself, because every register is 32 bit. Multiple register, why do we require multiple register? Our data is greater than 32 bit. Okay, that time we have used multiple registers. Either we copy multiple register data like R0, R1, something like that, multiple register data at a time into a memory location, or from the memory we'll copy more than 32 bit size data and store it in multiple register, because more than 32 bit will definitely require more than one register. Okay, that we will study in next class. Okay, so this is about single register load store data transfer instruction.